Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to this Webots Python tutorial. In today's video, I will talk about how to use Python 3 for Webots on Ubuntu. Since there are a lot of versions of Python 3, I will also show you which versions will work based on the Webots version you have installed and how to upgrade your current version of Python 3 to the version you want. I've included all of the timings here and in the description below. If you have any questions or doubts, ask in the comments section below. So without further ado, let's get into it. Let's start by starting Webots and creating a Python controller so we can test if Python 3 works or not. If you already have this set up, you can skip ahead. I'm creating a new world and calling it my project test Python. Next, I'm adding epoch robot in my Webots world. As you can see, the default controller is in C. So let's add our own Python controller in Webots. We do this by clicking on wizards and selecting new robot controller. Click next and make sure to select Python as your programming language. I'm calling the code my controller test Python. Click next and then click finish. Let's enable the motor. I looked at the C code for motor names. You can also look at the epoch documentation on the Webots website. I'm going to speed through this section of code as I've covered it in another tutorial before. I'll add the link to the Python controller in Webots tutorial in the description below. Before we move ahead, make sure you're selecting the Python controller under the epoch controller option. Simply click on controller, click on select, look through the list for your code, select it and press OK. Make sure to save your work and let's run the code. As you can see, I get this warning that Python 2.7 is at the end of its life. This means that my Webots is currently running Python 2.7 on this computer. Let's reset the Webots world. Now let's use Python 3 in Webots. On the Webots menu bar, click on Tools and then Preferences. As you can see, the Python command option says Python. Let's make it Python 3 and select OK. Let's run the Webots simulation again by clicking on play. As you can see in the console output, it is using Python 3. If this is not working for you, let me show you what to do next. Also, it only says using Python 3, but I don't know which version of Python 3 is being used. Let's go to the terminal. I'm opening a new tab and making it large so it's easy to see. You can check Python version with the command python dash dash version. Similarly, you can check Python 3 version with command python 3 dash dash version. Now to get Python 3 working with Webots, you need to add Python 3 path to your environmental path variable. To get the path where Python 3 is installed, use the command which. So with which Python and which Python 3, you can get the path to where Python and Python 3 is installed on your computer. Next, to add this path to your path environment variable, use export. The command is path is equal to open quote dollar path semicolon, then the path to where Python 3 is installed and closed quote, and then press enter. To check that this path is set, use the command echo. As you can see, it was added to path. Try to run Webots again and it should work. If it still doesn't work, means you have a Python 3 version that might not be supported with the Webots version you have currently installed. So next, we'll look into how to upgrade your Python 3 version and which Python 3 versions are supported by the Webots version installed on your computer. First, let's look into how to update the Python 3 version. I'm using Dead Snake PPA and will go through all the steps. I will add the link in the description below. I went for Python 3, which is actually not supported by Webots for the current Webot release. In just a few minutes, I will go over how to find out which Python versions will work based on the Webots version you have installed. We can again check the version of Python and Python 3. As you can see, Python 3 still says Python 3.5. So what's going on? Python, Python 3, and Python 3.9 are now all available as three different options. So you need to call each of them as you need. Now you might read about aliases or symbolic links to have Python point to Python 3 or 3.9. I would recommend not to do this. You never know which application is using which version of Python and what will stop working if you use aliases or symlink. It's better to keep them separate and call upon them as you need them. Do make sure to add path of Python 3.9 to your environment variable. Next, I'm going to run Webots with Python 3.9. On the Webots menu bar, click on Tools and then Preferences. Let's make the Python command equal to Python 3.9 and select OK and run the simulation. As you can see, it doesn't work and I get the error, no module named controller. In other words, no controller module exists for Python 3.9 to be used by Webots. Controller in Webots are written in C or C++ and needs to be compiled for use by Python. This is already done for you by Webots for most versions. Depending on the Webots version you are running, this file may or may not exist. To check if this file exists, first go to Webots home directory. For Ubuntu, it is user local Webots. Here, cd stands for changing directory and ls stands for listing all the contents of your current directory. Next, go to library, controller, and list all the contents using ls. As you can see, there's nothing for Python 3.9. And this is why we got the error of missing controller module. Any Python version you see listed here will be supported. In my case, I can see Python 3.8 is supported with my current Webots version. So I'm going to go with Python 3.8. Let me also quickly show you how you can check all the Python versions installed on Ubuntu. Run ls /uber/bin/python *. This is assuming all of your Python versions are installed in user bin. Same as before, using dead snake, I will install Python 3.8. You can install any Python version that is supported by your release of Webots. Also, make sure to add path to your Python version to the environment variable path. With that, let's run Webots. Same as before, go to Webots menu bar, Tools and Preferences. Make Python command as Python 3.9, click OK and run the simulation. As you can see, this works as expected. If this still doesn't work for you, you can make Python command equal to the actual path to where your Python 3 version was installed. So for example, in this case, it would be user bin Python 3.9 and that should work for you. You might also enjoy the Webots tutorial series on my channel that will help you get started with running robot simulations in Webot. If you have any questions or doubts, please use the comment section below. If you find this video useful, make sure to give it a like, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.